They said that you're lucky it did not spread in your pancreas and your other intestines. They said you're a walking miracle that that big mass was ready to explode and spread all over. My name is Anibal Torres. I live in Humacao, Puerto Rico for the past 31 years. I have my daughter, my granddaughter, my wife. They've all been part of my cancer treatment, and I'm happy about that.
Hi, my name is Michelle Torres. I'm his daughter. You have to be there for your family member, be that support. I need him. My kids need him.
It was May of 2022. I'll never forget it, because it was Cinco de Mayo. I woke up with pain in my stomach. I couldn't eat breakfast, eat anything for 3 days. And my doctor said, you have to go to the hospital now and get a CT scan. The doctor came out and said, you have a big mass in your liver. I gave my daughter and her boyfriend all the results, the CD and everything.
The part that he didn't know, because he gave me the envelope, it was sealed. I said metastasis. So immediately I knew he had cancer, so I broke down.
I did not know I had cancer, I just knew I had a mass.
I told him, just, we have this. There's nothing impossible for God. We're gonna pray, we're gonna get the best doctors in Puerto Rico, we're gonna refer it and just hold on. And a referral from Marcia Cruz, she referred us to the clinical trials. So that's how we're here today and grateful.
I wanna thank you again. When the doctor interviewed me, Dr. Arocho, she said that it's a new medicine out that is working, and it's a good medicine. I'm gonna go for it. I'm definitely gonna go for it. No matter what happens, whatever, I'm gonna try. And I signed the papers quick. I wanna live. I wanna start the treatment as soon as possible. My father died in 21 of cancer in the stomach, my mother also. And I have 14 uncles, all of them passed away with cancer. Today I'm 66 and I'm grateful to be alive, and I'm happy that I made it. I didn't think I was gonna make it. They're giving me 3 treatments every 15 days. They said it's gonna be a 2-year oncology trial. Don't worry, once we get the mass smaller than 4, we're gonna operate you and you're gonna be brand new. They gave me hope. Oh, the first couple of months was real bad for me because my face got swollen. All my dentures got all loose. But once the medicine got into my system months after months, I was getting better. I'm eating better, I'm sleeping better, I'm doing everything better. I meditate every day and I'm grateful for living every day. I tell everybody, enjoy life as it goes on daily, and be happy and be thankful for the help that we're getting.
It's been a life changer for all of us. We value each other more, and we value the time. We're so grateful for this opportunity as a second chance for my dad and for us.
I do CT scan every 6 weeks for my liver. They tell me how the millimeter is going down from 11.9, like a softball, is down to 4.3 this week. I'm a minority, but I'm very grateful to the United States for helping everybody, and especially in Puerto Rico. There's a lot of cancer patients.
I would definitely like to tell Congress, thank you for funding this program.
Exactly.
Of the research clinical trials. But I do have to say that it's something needed, not only for us, but anyone that doesn't have this resources to pay for their own therapy. And we do advocate so that this program can keep on being funded, because we went through it, because we're living it, we're seeing the results.
I've been getting treatment for 1.5 years already. I need 6 more months of treatment. And so far, by the grace of God, it's working. Thanks to all the research that's coming out, I'm alive today and I'm grateful.